Hello, you're back with Beatle. We are back on Survivor IO. Today we're going to be going through the Path of Trials, the tryout challenge for the Dusk Direwolf. Participate in the tryout challenge first. Your starting floor will be determined depending on your challenge result. We get three chances. Just before we jump into that, I'll give you a quick view of who my character is. Here he is. So we are using the Light Chaser, level 72. We've got 12,886 attack, nearly 44,000 health. And on the sort of level ups here, we are level 69. I think we've managed to get to. Might actually be able to get this next one. HP another plus 500. Why not? And we're just going to jump straight into the Dusk Direwolf Tryout Challenge to see what this is like. Here we go. So it's actually been a while since I've been on this game, so I do wonder what is new. Here we go. Select skill, tap on a weapon skill and supplies to lock them. Interesting. Let's have a look. So here I go for the fire just because it's got the tech part. And if I can do the supercell as well, just because that lightning is also very good. Supplies wise, let's get the attack speed and attack damage. Plus, if we get the drill as well, I know that is also quite good. Let's just see how we get on with this. There we go. So it has been a while since I've actually been on this game, so I wonder if there is much new in terms of weapons and that sort of thing. Doesn't look like it, but Light Chaser, still my favourite, seems to do the most damage. I do have that Void Breaker as well, the one that sort of shoots the black holes. But here we go, this looks to be, it's just a sort of boss levels. Going down quite quickly though, to be fair, and my HP seems to be doing okay for the time being. If I knew it was bosses only, I probably wouldn't have got that sort of radar around me that does the damage based on proximity, as I don't think that's going to be as useful. But we will see how we go. I think the fire here is probably going to be the best. The sort of blue fire that is all over the floor, because I think I don't really have to aim that at all. That'll just do the damage to the boss as I'm running around. The old mutant mayor here. But here we go. Looks like he's just about dying. You can also see my pet, the little turtle there. I think he does a bit of damage. He is purple rarity, so I don't think he's the best, but I don't think he's too bad, to be fair. So hopefully he will actually help us a little bit in this. Here we go. Electromune Steel Gnasher. They come up with some very interesting names here, but seems to be pretty easy enough. Although, obviously, my HP now is taking a bit more of a hit, depending on now we're on level 3, I suppose. I also assume we don't want to run into those electric squares, so I'm just going to have to try and dodge as best I can, although definitely doing a bit more damage. Maybe I should have actually chose different weapons, so I'll see if we can maybe redo these in the future, see if I can get to a higher level, because I don't think I'm going to do as best as I perhaps could, but we will see. Yeah, still going, just under half HP now. I should be able to kill this guy, probably get to floor 4, and there we go, actually we completed it. I thought it would just be sort of endless until you die, but there we go, 7,344 kills in the tryout challenge. Now, I wonder what that actually leaves us in terms of the next steps. Here we go, tryout result. Your best result in the tryout challenge is floor 2. Your starting path of trials is floor 11. Did that mean I died? I'm not too sure. Or did I complete it? It didn't really make that obvious, but I'll confirm the tryout. And here we are at the Path of Trials, current floor 11. So we will give this a go and see what happens next. Here we go, we're on the select skills again. So obviously Light Chaser is already locked. We will keep the Destroyer, Supercell. I wonder how many we can actually pick here. Because if we can lock them all, I don't see why you wouldn't lock them all. Yeah, I think I'll just lock them all and see how that goes, because I don't think it can hurt to not lock them unless I'm sort of mistaken what is going on here, but we'll just go with that. It looks like I'm just giving myself more weapons here, so I'm not too sure. But yeah, floor 11, and if the floors on the previous one were anything to go by, this should be really difficult, but I'm not sure it scales quite like that, or it could be a quick death, but we will see. So far, no boss though, it's just the little sort of minions who aren't getting far at all, pretty much dying as soon as they spawn. I think the blue fire is doing all the damage to them, to be fair. And we've actually just moved up to floor 12 without really doing anything. As you can see, I don't even really need to even move. There we go, just even moved up to floor 13 and I haven't moved at all, so I will see when it gets a bit more tricky. So still not even had to move. We are on floor 16 now, and as you can see in the top right, we've collected 5 of those blue chests. We seem to get those every time we complete a floor. So I will keep going. Hopefully those blue chests are quite useful, but we will have to see at the end of this once we eventually die. Although looking at this, it could be a while. Here we go. Just as we reach floor 20, the first boss has arrived and he's down as quickly as he arrived. So now on floor 21 and still going very much strong. Here we go, just coming up to round 30, still not actually had to move. I presume there is going to be a boss appearing. Here is the Electromoon Steel Gnasher again, but he's going down a little slower than the last guy, but I have a feeling I've really started at floors well below my level, as I am absolutely destroying all the little guys up to this point. I'm still not really had to move, and my health isn't really going down. As you can see here, it's still all pretty much the same. What I'm going to do is end it on these 20 blue boxes that we can see on floor 31, and I will do future videos on this. I just want to see what these blue boxes are, so we will leave it there. I will just check to see what has done the most damage. Fuel Barrel, what I would have expected, and the Supercell Destroyer, and even the Shark Morgan, actually. I'm surprised the Eternal Light of the Light Chaser hadn't done that much. Well, I mean, it looks like by quitting, I actually don't get any of the achievements, so we can only get these to clear floor 10, which I actually did in the initial one, but clear floor 25, which I definitely did do, I actually can't get those achievements, so that is quite disappointing. So I will have to redo that again, but it looks like that is the loadout to be using on these Path of Trial modes. But yeah, if you have got this far, I do appreciate it. Please do like and subscribe. I will be carrying on both on these trials and the main battle, Foothill Disorder, on some of my future videos. But yeah, thank you, catch you in the next one.